Hi students, welcome to another session of my class. We are discussing Candide by Voltaire. Let us continue the summary of the novel Candide. Chapter 5. A furious storm overtakes Candide's ship on its way to Lisbon. Yes, the previous chapter, that is in the chapter 4, we saw that yes, this Jacques and Candide, they set out a journey to Lisbon. So on the way to Lisbon, a storm overtakes the ship as it arrives in the Bay of Lisbon. And Jacques tries to take command of the ship, but is hit by a soldier who falls into the water by the force of his own punch. Jacques tries to save a sailor who has almost fallen overboard. Jacques rescues the sailor who has hit him but falls into the water as he does so. Jacques saves the sailor, but he falls overboard himself and the sailor does not help him. Does nothing to help him. And the sailor lets him drown. And when Candide attempts a rescue, the Candide tries to save this Jacques. Suddenly this Pangloss explains that he must not. Yes, you do not do that. Pangloss replied that. And he argues that the Bay of Lisbon was created specifically to drown Jacques. That was his reply, Pangloss. That is, this Bay of Lisbon is, yes, was created specifically to drown Jacques. That is his optimistic philosophy. Everything, all action or everything is for the best of the world. So he argues that the Bay of Lisbon was created specifically to drown Jacques. The ship breaks apart and Pangloss and Candide float on a plank to Lisbon. That is, they manage to survive. As soon as they arrive, the Lisbon earthquake takes place. Yes. The ship sinks and Pangloss, Candide and sailor are the only survivors. They reach shore and walk toward Lisbon. Lisbon has just experienced a terrible earthquake and is in ruins. Yes, as soon as they arrive, the Lisbon earthquake takes place and more than 30,000 people die. The sailor finds some money in the ruins and promptly gets drunk and pays a woman for sex. Yes, that is, he is trying to make benefit of that ruined or damaged place, etc. The sailor finds some money in the ruins and promptly gets drunk and pays a woman for sex. Meanwhile, the groans of dying and buried victims rise from the ruins. Yes, the situation of that place is not at all fair. It is very pathetic. That is, almost 30,000 people died because of this terrible earthquake, and in between that, so many buildings are collapsed. And meanwhile, the groans of dying and buried victims, they rise from the ruins. Pangloss and Candide help the wounded, and Pangloss comforts the victims by telling them the earthquake is for the best. Yes. They try to help these people. These wounded people, that is, Pangloss and Candide help the wounded, and also the Pangloss comforts the victims by telling them the earthquake is for the best. That is, again he said his optimistic, that it is because of the, yes, earthquake is for the best of the all possible worlds. One of the officers of the Inquisition accuses Pangloss of heresy, because an optimist cannot possibly believe in original sin. Yes, one of the officers of the Inquisition, that is related with the church affairs, he accuses Pangloss of heresy because of his philosophy. He accuses this Inquisition, the officers of the Inquisition, so they accuse Pangloss of heresy because an optimist cannot possibly believe in original sin. The fall and punishment of man, the Catholic Inquisitor claims, prove that everything is not for the best. Yes. The Catholic Inquisitor, that is something related with the religious, Catholic religious institutions, and he argues that, or he proved that the fall and the punishment of man prove that everything is not for the best. But his philosophy, that is Pangloss philosophy, is everything, even the earthquake is for the best. Each and every action is for the best. And the drowning of the jackass itself is considered as, yes, the Bay of Lisbon is, yes, created specifically for the drowning of jackass. Such type of philosophy that he is upheld in his life, that is Pangloss. So, this Catholic Inquisitor proved that everything is not for the best. The fall and punishment of man, it is a doctrine that related with the Catholic, especially Catholic belief, the original sin, the fall and the punishment of man, all these preachings or these things are closely related with the Catholic doctrine. Through some rather twisted logic, Pangloss attempts to defend his theory. Again, he is trying to support or defend his theory with the help of some twisted logic sayings or incidents or examples, something like that. That is, he always believed in optimistic philosophy. So in this chapter, we can see the mainly two incidents. First one is Jacques the Anabaptist is allowed to die by a man he has just rescued. That is in the first part of this chapter. Almost tens of thousands of innocent people die in the earthquake. That is the second incident in this chapter. Both of these events challenge the idea of divine justice. That is the important thing in this chapter. Both of these incidents, that is the death of Jacques and the death of thousands of people die in the earthquake. Both of these events challenge the idea of divine justice, that God has created a fair world where the good are rewarded and the innocent are safe. Yes, here he questions the ideal, that divine justice, that God has created a fair world and where the good are rewarded and the innocent are safe. Actually, here is question, challenge the idea, this idea. And moreover, Pangloss' ridiculous attempt to explain that the Bay of Lisbon was created specifically to cause Jacques drowning is a further example of his philosophy's inability or meaninglessness. That is, to convincingly connect the world's chaos to a harmonious divine plan. He failed to connect his philosophy with the reality existed in the world. Here, his futile attempt to explain that the Bay of Lisbon was created precisely to cause Jacques drowning. It is a futile, it is a meaningless doctrine or meaningless ideal here. And from these things, we can understand that, yes, it is an example of his philosophy's inability or, yes, its futility or meaninglessness, that is, to convincingly connect the world's chaos to a harmonious divine plan. Then this bit of slapstick humor further emphasizes Pangloss' detachment from the world. And moreover, he does not try to understand or comprehend the world in its fullest sense. His philosophies or his teachings or this type of optimistic belief shows that his detachment from the real world. He would rather argue and reason about the earthquake than deal with its dire and immediate consequences and help a friend. Actually, he is trying to argue. He would argue and reason about the earthquake and said that the earthquake is for the best. So, He would rather argue and reason about the earthquake than deal with its dire and immediate or the pathetic situations of that place and help a friend, etc. He's always tried to uphold his teachings and his belief to others. And his consolation consists mostly in repeating what has happened. And from all these incidents, readers can understand that his philosophy is an utter foolishness, or it is pure, it is meaninglessness or useless in determining the truth, but also in offering sympathy and comfort to some people. And moreover, worse, this reasoning gets Pangloss into serious trouble with the religious powers that have a different interpretation of the world. And moreover, at the end of this chapter, we can see that he gets into an argument with a Catholic inquisitor, that is, officers of the church, and they accused Pangloss of heresy, because an optimist cannot possibly believe in original sin. And the fall and punishment of man, this is considered as the original sin according to Catholic doctrine. So the Catholic inquisitor claims to prove that everything is not for the best. So these are the important points that discussed in the chapter 5. Then chapter 6. The Portuguese authorities decide to burn a few people alive to prevent future earthquakes. Yes, the religious scholars of Lisbon determine that an auto da fé, that means a contemporary ritual for the punishment of sinners and heretics, that was a ritual that existed in that place, that Lisbon. The religious scholars of Lisbon, they decided a contemporary ritual for the punishment of sinners and heretics is the best way to prevent further earthquakes. So the Portuguese authorities decide to burn a few people alive to prevent future earthquakes. And as a result, they choose one man because he has married his godmother. These Portuguese authorities or these religious scholars, they choose one man because he has married his godmother, and they consider it as a sin or a heretic. And two others because they have refused to eat bacon. And the authorities hang Pangloss for his opinions. Yes, Pangloss is laid off to be hung for his heresy because he always upheld that optimistic belief. So the authorities hang Pangloss for his opinions and publicly flog candidate for listening with an air of approval. And candidate was also punished because he always is listening to his meaningless philosophy. And candidate to be wiped for having listened with the approval. So the auto de fé, that means that religious ritual takes place amid sermons and beautiful church music. This ritual was carried on in between sermons, church sermons and beautiful church music. At the end of the day, an aftershock of the earthquake takes place. Yes. When another earthquake occurs later the same day, candidate finds himself doubting that this is the best of all possible worlds. Candidate expresses anguish for the loss of Pangloss. Now Pangloss, yes, he lost that his friend, tutor Pangloss, and Cunegonde, that is, in the first chapter itself, he lost his lady love Cunegonde. And moreover, he witnessed so many dark experiences, that is, the loss of that friend Jacques. And when another earthquake occurs later the same day, that is, candidate finds himself doubting. He further doubts about the intrinsic goodness of the world. He's doubting that this is best of all possible worlds. He is doubting because of all the previous experiences from the first chapter up to the sixth chapter. He experienced and he also traveled so many places. He met with so many people and he yes understands so many dark realities of this life. And now at present he doubts that this is the best of all possible worlds. Yes, so that religious ritual, that is, and the aftershock that follows it mocked the idea that religious faith might impact events in the world. Clearly, the sins of Candide and Pangloss had nothing to do with the earthquake, actually. There is no relationship between this Pangloss philosophy or Candide's approval to his philosophy. There is no relationship between this earthquake and Pangloss philosophy. Clearly, the sins are sins. They considered these religious officers or the Portuguese authorities, they considered this Pangloss optimistic belief as heresy, that is, as they considered as sin. And this candidate's listening with an air of approval, that is his approval, or he is listening to this candidate all time, he is listening to Pangloss philosophy with an air of approval. That is also considered as a sin by these religious officers. And we can quote that in inverted commas, sins, because these religious officers consider this as sins. So clearly the sins of Candide and Pangloss had nothing to do with the earthquake. Actually, we can see that there is no inherent relationship between their belief or their teachings as well as earthquake. Another happens just after they have been punished. Yes, another earthquake occurs later the same day. So the juxtaposition of beautiful religious music with the horrifying punishments emphasizes the disparity between the church's aura of holiness and the senseless violence it causes. Yes, at the same time, we readers get the idea, or we readers can see that, yes, the background of the punishment, yes, they did this punishment with the help of some chanting some sermons and beautiful church music, etc. So the juxtaposition of beautiful religious music with the horrifying punishments, at the opposite side is the horrible punishment, and the one side is the beautiful religious music, that sermons, chanting sermons, etc. So the juxtaposition of beautiful religious music with the horrifying punishments emphasizes the disparity between the church's aura of holiness. Yes, we all have a idea in our mind that is, yes, the church is purely for holiness. And we get an aura of holiness from these chanting of sermons, beautiful music, etc. From this chapter, we readers get the idea, or we readers can understand, there is a here he tried to express that disparity between the church's aura of holiness and the senseless violence it causes. From the yes, with the help of these religious rituals or their belief, they tried to inflict senseless violence upon innocent people. They choose one man because he has married his godmother. They consider these religious inquisitors or the Portuguese authorities, they consider it as a sin. And two others because they have refused to eat bacon. And then next, Pangloss philosophy or his teachings, that itself is considered as a heresy or considered as sin. And candidates listening with an air of approval to that philosophy, that itself is considered as sin. So one side is the that church's aura of holiness, and the other side is the senseless violence it causes. We can see that that why, with the help of that religious teachings or religious power, with the help of that religious power, they inflict senseless violence upon innocent people or the poor people. We can get that notion clearly from this chapter. Next is chapter 7. Just then, an old woman approaches Candide. An old woman comes across Candide and convinces him to come home with her. She takes care of him, but does not reveal why she is doing so. This old woman approaches Candide, feeds his wounds, gives him new clothes and feeds him, but does not reveal why she is doing so. After several days, she leads him to a house in the country and then brings a veiled woman to him from the upstairs room. Yes, after some days, this old woman leads him to a house in the country and then brings a veiled woman to him from the upstairs room. When Candide removes the veil, he finds Cunegonde. Once he lost his lady love, that is in the first chapter itself, he lost his, he banished from the castle. And now, at present, yes, he finds Cunegonde is under the veil. The two faint with joy and surprise. After so many years, they, yes, united. Cunegonde explains that she survived the attack. Yes, in the previous chapter itself, we readers get the idea that castle of Baron, it was attacked by some Bulgar army. They killed almost all people and raped Cunegonde, and she is managed to survive from that attack. Cunegonde explains that she survived the attack and asks to hear what has happened to Candide in the time since their faithful kiss. Yes, in the first chapter itself, he was banished from the castle because they made some lovemaking. And Baron, he saw that, or he identified the relationship between Cunegonde and Candide, and Baron banished the Candide from the castle. And now Cunegonde asked him to tell what has happened to him after he has banished from the castle. That is chapter 7. That is, for the second time, a character thought to be dead returns in disguise. That is Cunegonde. We all, we readers from the previous chapter, we can get the idea that we got the idea that almost all characters were attacked and they were died, and this Cunegonde was raped by the attackers, etc. So for the second time, a character thought to be dead returns in disguise, that is Cunegonde. These surprise returns are part of the novels. That is, he used the narrative technique here. These surprise returns, actually this is a surprise return, one of the characters. So these surprise returns are part of the novels. It is back and forth between disillusionment and optimism. Actually, it is a type of narrative technique he used, that is the back and forth between disillusionment and optimism. The synchronized painting satirizes the gestures and conventions of traditional romance, that is, that they expressed their happiness, or the two faint with joy and surprise. That all shows the conventions of traditional romance. I think all of you understand the chapter 7. Next is chapter 8. And Cunegonde, yes, after Candide finishes telling his story, Cunegonde tells Candide what has happened to her. Yes, Cunegonde explains to Candide that the Bulgars have killed her family. When the attack on Thunder Ten Tranche took place, that is the castle of Baron, she was asleep in bed. A Bulgarian soldier began raping her and cut her on the left side when she resisted. While this was happening, the soldier's superior officer entered the room and killed him not for raping Kinegonde, but for failing to properly salute. After that, the Bulgarian captain took Kinegonde into captivity. Yes, here Kinegonde explains to Candide what has happened to her. So, after executing a soldier whom he found raping Kinegonde, Bulgar captain took Kinegonde as his mistress and later sold her to a Jew named Don Issachar. The Bulgarian captain sold Kinegonde to Don Issachar, a Jew, who took her to live in his country house, the very house where Kinegonde is telling this story to Candide. At present, she is in Don Issachar's house. That is the very house where Kinegonde is telling this story to Candide. One day at Mass, that is Catholic religious ritual, one day at Mass, the Grand Inquisitor took a liking to Kinegonde. An attempt to bargain with Don Issachar for her. When he refused to trade her, the inquisitor threatened him with an auto da fe. That means again this inquisitor threatened Don Issachar with the name of same religious ritual. Eventually, they came to an agreement. That is, this Grand Inquisitor and the Don Issachar, they came to an agreement. What was the agreement? To share this Kinegonde. On the day of the auto da fe, the Grand Inquisitor brought Kinegonde to watch. When she saw Pangloss executed and Candide wife, she cried out in horror. Yes. On the day of the auto da fe, in the previous chapter, we saw that these Portuguese officers, they tried to execute some people publicly. Yes, with the help of the religious power. That is, on the day of the auto da fe, the Grand Inquisitor brought Kinegonde to watch. And this Grand Inquisitor, he allowed Kinegonde to watch all these doings. And when she saw Pangloss executed and Candide wiped, she cried out in horror. Later, she arranged for the old woman to look for Candide and bring him to her. There, Kinegonde concludes her story, and just as she does, Don Issachar arrives to the home. This is chapter 7. So, here, the soldier's lack of respect for his superior seems like a trivial crime in comparison with his brutal violation of Kinegonde. Yes, from the previous chapter itself, we readers got the idea about the rude behavior or the military life. We got a definite idea about the military life, the Bulgarian army. So here, the soldier's lack of respect. Here, one soldier, he is trying to rape Kinegonde. And the soldier's lack of respect. And the superior entered into the room and this soldier did not respect him. So the soldier's lack of respect for his superior seems like a trivial crime. And that lack of respect here considered as a serious crime in comparison with his brutal violation of Kinegonde. Actually, he is trying to rape this innocent girl. And this lack of respect is considered as a serious crime compared with the violence or the his brutal violation of Kinegonde. That is the satirical element here. And moreover, or nevertheless, the captain kills the soldier merely for refusing to salute, not for raping this innocent girl. This soldier, the superior, executed that soldier. It is because of that lack of respect, not for his brutal violence towards that innocent girl. Military hierarchy is made to look ridiculous, and Cunegonde continues to be abused by nearly every man she encounters. Yes, she's continued to be abused. That is, then the soldier, the superior, considers her as his mistress. Then he sold him to a Jew named Don Isajar. Then this grand inquisitor happened to see her and wanted to buy her. Then they made an agreement, that is, what was the agreement? That is, two agreed to share Cunegonde. The grand inquisitor would have her 4 days a week, and Don Isajar the other three. That is, a week, that is 7 days, is divided, that is 4 and 3. 4 days she spent with the grand inquisitor, and 3 days she spent with Don Isajar. That means Cunegonde continues to be abused by nearly every man she encounters. And the constant exchange of Cunegonde, which continues through the novel, underscores the treatment of women as property. Yes, another notion we get from this chapter, that is, women, the treatment of women. Here, the women is just considered as a property. That constant exchange of Cunegonde from one hand to another which continues throughout the novel, it underscores the treatment of women as property. They considered women just as a property, never considered as a human being. The inquisitor's threat of an auto da fe against Don Isajar is an example of the hypocrisy and abuse of power by church figures in the novel. Yes, the grand inquisitor, he is closely associated with the Catholic Church. Actually, he is the one who protects the law, divine law, etc. But here, with the help of that hypocrisy and religious power, he is trying to threaten Don Isajar for that girl. The inquisitor's threat of an auto da fe against Don Isajar is an example of the hypocrisy and abuse of power. Yes, that incident shows the abuse of religious power. Moreover, hypocrisy and abuse of power by church figures in the novel. They are misusing these religious figures. They are misusing their religious power. The grand inquisitor is supposed to be a man who does not have sexual relations with women. Yes, he is closely related with the Catholic church doings, etc. And actually, it is prohibited to him. He is supposed to be a man who does not have sexual relations with women. But here he is threatening an official religious killing just to force Don Isajar to give him Cunegonde. But here we can see that here, with the help of this religious power, he is trying to threaten Don Isajar for that girl. That means he is trying to misuse his religious power and inflict violence upon the poor people. And he is supposed to protect this people in the name of divine role or divine etc., divinity, etc. That is, he is closely associated with the religious institution, and he is supposed to protect all the innocent people from all types of violences. But here he is threatening an official religious killing just to force Don Isajar to give him Cunegonde. And Don Isajar's sudden arrival at the end of Cunegonde's story is an instance of something that happens often in Candide. A swift reversal after every success or reunion. Yes, at the end of this chapter, we can see that this Don Isajar came to. Suddenly, as Don Isajar's sudden arrival at the end of Cunegonde's story It is an example, or it is an instance of something that happens often in Candidae. That is a swift reversal after every success or reunion. This is one aspect of the novel's comically fast pacing. So these are the important elements that is in the 7th and 8th chapter. I think all of you understand this section, that is chapter 5, 6, 7 and 8. That is Candidae's Jacques and Pangloss. They set out a journey to Bay of Lisbon, and this Jacques drowned at the Bay of Lisbon. And throughout the novel, this Pangloss upheld the philosophy that is optimistic, that is everything is for the best. And they reached this Lisbon. Thousands of people met with a severe earthquake, and thousands of people died. And at that time also, this Pangloss upheld the same philosophy that earthquake was for the best of the world. And some religious people, that is religious officers, or this they consider it as heresy. And with the help of this religious power, or the name of religious rituals, they executed Pangloss and wiped Candidae, and some other innocent people were also executed with the name of this religious ritual. From these incidents, we can see that is at the one side, we readers get the notion that church or the religious institutions is a symbol of holiness. And here, with the help of these same religious institutions, they try to inflict severe violences or brutal violences on the innocent or the poor people of that society. Actually, they are trying to misuse their power, religious power. And after so many years, Candidae happened to see his lady love, Cunegonde, and she explained what has happened to her. And after she was raped by a soldier, and so a superior entered into that room, and this soldier failed to respect that superior, and this was considered as a serious crime when compared to Cunegonde's or the raping of Cunegonde. After executing a soldier whom he found raping a Bulgar captain, took Cunegonde as his mistress. Then after that, and this Cunegonde, is the violence or the brutal violence towards Cunegonde is never considered as a serious crime, and that lack of respect is considered as a serious crime and punished him, that is executed that soldier. That is another satirical element. And this superior or Bulgar captain, he took Cunegonde as his mistress, then sold her to a Jew, Don Izajar. Then this grand inquisitor, that is a church official, happened to see her, and he wants this little girl. These incidents, we can understand that yes, here the treatment of women characters, they never considered this woman as a human beings, only considered as a property for enjoyment. And she continuously become a victim of abuse. Then the two agreed to share Cunegonde, this Grand Inquisitor and Don Izajar. That is 4 days with the Grand Inquisitor and 3 days with the Don Izajar. At last, yes, the story of this chapter 8 ends with the arrival of Don Izajar to that home. And it also shows that something that is going to happen, just that maybe happened after the reunion, etc. So these are the main elements that discussed in the chapter 5, 6, 7 and 8. So write a note on the satirical elements or the summary of chapter 5, 6, 7 and 8. That is your homework. Write your homework and send back to me. Thank you. Have a nice day. See you again.